There are five distinct layers of our atmosphere, identified by temperature, chemical composition, movement, and density. Between the layers, there are pauses where the greatest changes of these identifiers occur. The layer that we live in at the Earth's surface is called the troposphere, part of the lower atmosphere. The troposphere extends 4 to 12 miles high and is where the majority of all weather occurs, which includes cloud formation. The height of the troposphere varies based on location. At the equator, it's at its highest, and it's at its lowest at the poles. Air is the warmest at the Earth's surface, or the bottom of the troposphere. Moving upward in the atmosphere, gases become less dense and air becomes thinner. Near the ground, temperatures average 62 degrees Fahrenheit and around negative 60 degrees Fahrenheit at the tropopause, the boundary between the troposphere and the stratosphere. The stratosphere is the layer of the atmosphere directly above the troposphere, extending about 31 miles above the Earth's surface. The bottom of the stratosphere varies depending on the season and latitude. This layer contains 19% of the atmospheric gases, but very little water vapor, so few clouds are found here. Airplanes usually fly at the lower level of the stratosphere to reduce turbulence and increase visibility. In the stratosphere, temperature increases with height, even though it is still very cold, ranging from negative 60 degrees Fahrenheit at the tropopause to 5 degrees Fahrenheit at the top of this layer. The stratosphere warms due to heat produced by the formation of ozone. The ozone layer found in the stratosphere protects our planet like sunscreen does for your skin. This layer absorbs harmful UVC and UVB rays from the sun. UV rays constantly break down and reform ozone and oxygen molecules in the ozone layer. Ozone can form near the ground, known as smog, which can cause lung damage and asthma attacks. Fortunately, 90% of ozone is in the stratosphere. Certain materials that enter the stratosphere can stay there for a long time, such as ozone-destroying chemicals called CFCs. Most CFCs are introduced into the atmosphere due to human activity. Natural disasters like large volcanic eruptions can introduce aerosols into the stratosphere, where they can linger for months to years and sometimes alter Earth's global climate. Next time, watch to learn about the upper atmosphere. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to Mr. Weather's World on YouTube for new videos every Mr. Weather Wednesday.